How do researchers study the vast amount of DNA in the cells of an organism such as a human? One way is to create a DNA library, which is a collection of DNA fragments that come from one organism and that are stored in another organism, often a bacterium. To create a human DNA library, a researcher begins by extracting and purifying DNA from human cells. The purified DNA consists of extremely long DNA strands. To begin working with the DNA, the strands must first be cut into manageable sizes. The DNA is therefore digested with restriction enzymes, which cut the DNA at specific sequences. The restriction enzymes cut the DNA into thousands of smaller fragments, each of which may contain one or more genes. Although we show just a few fragments, let's suppose they represent all of the DNA that exists in human cells. The colors indicate that the fragments are different and have unique DNA sequences. To create the library, each fragment must be inserted into loops of DNA called plasmids. A plasmid is a type of vector that allows the DNA to be shuttled into bacteria. The plasmids are digested with the restriction enzymes and then sealed to the human DNA using the DNA ligase enzyme. The resulting molecules are recombinant. The recombinant DNA molecules are added to bacteria, and the bacteria are made to take up the DNA. When the bacteria have taken up the DNA, the entire collection of cells and DNA represents a human DNA library. The recombinant plasmids remain separate from the bacteria's own DNA, making it easy to extract again. To analyze any of the DNA fragments, the bacteria are grown on a rich medium that allows them to reproduce and make more of the recombinant DNA. This form of the library allows a researcher to analyze unique human DNA fragments and locate the fragments that contain the genes that the researcher wants to study.